Ceramics and welcome back to another Christmas themed video. In today's video I will be showing you how to make a Christmas bell. I will be showing you two variants, one that is a bit easier than the other one. So just keep on watching and find out for yourself which one you'd like to make. I start off with centering the clay. I do this by coning it up and pushing it down. I repeat this multiple times. Then I start opening up the shape. I'm throwing the bell upside down, so the part that's attached to the wheel is going to be the top of the bell. I will be trimming the top round. That's why I make the inside round as well. Because of this, the walls of the clay might be a bit thicker at the bottom than that you're used to when making cups and bowls. Then I start building up the walls. As always, I hold my left hand on the inside and push with my right hand on the outside while making an upwards movement. I repeat this multiple times to make the piece higher and to make the walls thinner. Then I start to make the shape of a bell. You can make them in a lot of different shapes. I like to make the middle part a little bit round. I do this by pushing from the inside out. I also like to pull the rim of the pot outwards to get this bell form. When I'm happy with the shape, I get rid of the slip and the water that's on it. I do this by going over it with a dry sponge. Then I get rid of the excess clay at the bottom of the piece and clean the bed. After the piece has dried for a day and it's leather hard, I start trimming it. As I said earlier, I am trying to make the top as round as possible. I keep going over it with my trimming tool and take away clay from the sides. When the top was round, I took these smaller hands from the Give and Grip so that I could trim the side of the piece as well. By going over the whole piece, I made the shape a bit more fluent. When I'm done with trimming, I like to go over it with a sponge and then get rid of the slip by going over it with a trimming tool that isn't sharp, so it doesn't trim. This might seem a bit weird, but it works for me. And then I go over it with my finger to smooth it out even more. And then the trimming part is done. I will now show you two ways of making the bell so that you can hang it and put a little ball in it. The first way is very easy. You can just make a hole at the top of the bell and use a string to hang it. After making the hole, I smooth it out with a sponge. If you don't have a hole maker, you could also make a little hole while trimming by pushing your needle tool into it. The second way you can do it is a bit more complicated, but does give a better result in my opinion. I start off with rolling out some clay very thin. I do this by going over it with my hands on the table like this. Then I bend it and I cut it shorter. I'm going to place this little hook on the inside of the bell. After it is fired, you will be able to hang the clapper on the inside without seeing the string on the outside. To attach it, I first press it on the place where I want to attach it. This will leave two little marks. It's a bit hard to see, I barely see it myself, but I'll try to explain what I do. I now scratch the parts where the little hook is going to be attached. I use my needle tool to do this. Then I apply some vinegar with a brush at the same two spots. And I scratch it again with the needle tool. Then I press the little hook inside it. This is quite hard because you won't be able to see what you're doing since your hand is in the way. When you've found the right spot, hold it for a bit at the right place so it gets stuck and has some time to dry. And then I use the vinegar brush again to smooth out the edges of the hook. Here is a closer look to what it looks like. Then I start making a handle for the bell. I roll out some clay again, but leave it thicker this time. I keep rolling until I have the thickness that I like. Then I go over it with my finger. By doing this, I make it a bit flatter and also smooth it out. Then I bend the handle into a shape that I like and cut off the excess clay. I would recommend to let the handle dry a bit before attaching it to the bell, otherwise it might crack. Then I hold the handle on top of the bell and mark with my needle tool the place where I want to attach it. Then I scratch this place with a needle tool. Apply some vinegar and scratch it again. Then I place the handle in the right spot and put some pressure on it. After this, I use the vinegar brush to smooth out the edges. Now I will be making the clapper, if that's what it's called. You can make this in any shape you want. I prefer to keep it simple and just make a little bowl. I make a hole in this to be able to hang it on the inside of the bell. And then smooth out the edges of the hole. After the bells have been biscuit fired, I start glazing them. I decided to glaze them with the bubble glaze technique. I'm not going to explain how to do this because it's quite difficult, but I have made a full instruction video about this on my channel, so you might like to check this out. I'll link it down below and on the end of the video. I make one of the bells green and the other one red. After the bubbles have dried, I apply 2 coats of zinc-free clear glaze from Emeco. I glaze the inside and the outside. To prevent the bells to get stuck to the kiln shelf, I rub it on top of this wet piece of fabric. And then they are ready to be fired for a second time. Then I hang the clippers inside the bells with a string. If you struggle with getting the string through the hole, an iron wire might help. And this is what the bells look like and sound like. That was it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked and learned something new from it. If so, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't also yet. And if you're going to make these bells yourself and you're going to post them on Instagram, please tag me at @callceramic so I can see your work, because I really enjoy that. And I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!